Oh, it feels, it's been really great. You know, when I got a call and when we started talking about this, I thought it was a joke. So have you really, really called me? So I was quite happy when I came to know that they want to feature me. Yes, it really feels great. So I feel honored. Thanks to Mr. Hira and thanks to Nandini.
You're known as Mahadev. You're also known as the Greek god of the Indian television industry. Has the serial changed your life?
Yeah, the fact that the serial has been over for more than 2.5 years and we are still discussing that. So it has completely changed my life forever. The series changed me, my career. It made me who I am. It got me the love and affection of everybody. It got me name, fame, whatever a small town boy like me is looking for in the city. So, yeah, that was the changing factor.
So right now you're touching the skies. You're a very big name in the television fraternity. Someday, if you get a chance, would you give up television for Bollywood?
I don't think so. I won't give up television because...
So you'll keep doing both?
Yes. In fact, when we see the lot of people who are doing the series that come on television, with a lot of film stars coming on television as well. So the medium is growing day by day, so, and the reach is phenomenal. So I don't think at any given point I would leave the box.
Alright. So like camps exist in the Bollywood industry, do they exist in the television fraternity as well?
To an extent, I think. Yeah, to an extent. Camps as in there are certain people who are... friendly with the team, and they have a camaraderie with the team, and they decide to work together all the time. So that makes them that makes a so-called camp, where the producers and the actors are on the same wavelength and the thought process is the same, and they want to achieve something very different. So they work again and again, and it becomes a sort of a camp in television.
All right, thank you so much, Mohit. The floor is open to the media to ask questions. Kindly raise your hands.
Mohit, your show was such a long-running one, breaking all records. So what do you feel is the reason for this mythological God-based show? What was the reason for its popularity?
See, there were a lot of factors attached to it. The first and the foremost important factor in television is that when you look the part, the half the battle is won. So I was blessed enough to kind of look the calendar image, which we have always seen. I don't take any credit for that. It just happened with me. I was just blessed. And later on, things just fell in place. And at the same time, we were focusing more on the personal story. We were not showcasing him as a god who will just make decisions or who would just do the good things for people. It was more about his personal life, his shortcomings, his journey of from a hermit to achieving a household. So that journey kind of in Shiva is a god which everybody is attached to in some or the other way. And
Shiva is a god who is very angry, supposed to be very angry god. How angry are you in real life?
Me? Not much. Not much. I just played the character. I am not that. Hi.
First of all, I used to watch Mahadev, even though I don't watch any TV, only for you.
Thank you.
Can you remember any crazy fan moments while you were playing the role of Shiva?
Oh, loads of them.
Can you share some?
So there was this particular incident that had happened. During Shivratri, the Mahashivratri. So, first, just going back from the question. So, I am a Kashmiri Brahmin. So, we have Mahashivratri as one of our biggest rituals and pujas that we do. So, it's been like since the time since my birth, we have been celebrating Mahashivratri on a very huge scale. So that was the first year of the show. So when I applied for the leave, that I wanted the leave for like 4 days. And that was happening during the Shivratri period. So my leave was rejected. So I was quite, said, you can't take the leave because we need to pray you. We need you. So that was the first time I had to miss the prayers at home. So during that period, there was a family who wanted me to come and pay visit to their new house that they had bought, which unfortunately I couldn't do because we were short of time. So he made a video call. He said, okay, while I'm entering the house, I'll do a video call. And during that period, you just be on the video call and you'll see the house and I'll enter with you. So I said, fair enough. So for his happiness, I had to enter with him on that video call.
Thanks. Thanks
very
much. Yeah.
बहुत जल्दी actually working on the next show, which is taking a lot of time. I think it should be out hopefully in January. That's something that I'm working on right now. That's why I am in this shape right now. I can't really reveal much about it, but yeah, it should be out very soon.
Mohit, considering that more casting female directors are around now, and even executive producers are mostly females, do you feel that the trend of casting couch exists in the TV industry as well?
Sorry, say that again, please.
Since there are a lot of casting directors who are ladies, females,
mm-hmm.
and even executive producers are females,
mm-hmm.
do you feel that the casting couch trend exists in the television industry as well?
I don't think so. No, I don't agree with that, because we have to understand that it has become very, there's a structure that you have to follow. There's a pattern, it's all very corporate, you know. It's not something that's a very one and on a personal decision by a particular person. So there's the call has to be taken by the project head, then your creative directors involved, then there's the directors involved, then your producers involved. So I don't think that entirely any one individual has the power to get you a job or something of that sort. So I don't think it exists in the television industry.
Yes. After Mahadev, you said that you will play the role of Lord Shiva. Why was that?
Because there was nothing to do in his story. We had finished the entire Shiv Puran. So once we realized that we have finished the Shiv Puran and we couldn't go out of it, so we had to close it. So there was no point of me playing it again.
Yes. You have played roles of Mahadev, Ashoka. So how much are you addicted of playing roles which are larger than life?
Very badly. I don't know how to come out of it now. Because the one that I am again doing is again based on a real life incident. So I think what drives me towards it is that you already know the story. The story doesn't need to be completely developed on a very on a regular basis, on a weekly or a monthly basis. Otherwise, what usually happens in television is that you have a broader story and you keep working on it in a week or 2 weeks time. But when you have a story which is more about larger than life characters and when it's a real life incident, so the story is already there. So you know that, okay, I'll have to just be the part of this story which has a beginning and an end as well. So there's nothing that can go wrong or that will not set you free. So I think I've gotten addicted to that. And it comes with a lot of responsibility as well. It you have to make sure that you give your best, which I'm trying.
Thank you.
What about Bollywood dreams, man?
I think I'm more than satisfied right now in television.
At one time you were trying to get into Bollywood,
right? I wasn't trying. I mean, see, there were a lot of things that were happening, but there was nothing very, something that really I wanted to start with. So that's why I didn't take it up. I've been in talks with a lot of people, but I want to start it with something very, very, very different, you know, and my needs, the creative greed is being satisfied on the Idiot Box right now. So I'm more than happy.
No,
no, no. Me? Oh. No, I don't think so.
You know, you have a personality.
Thank you.
The casting couch doesn't exist, you said, in the TV industry. What about nepotism?
Not at all.
Nepotism doesn't exist.
No,
in
no.
Television.
I think talent will never have any dearth of work. All these words and definitions we can use till the time we can. But at the end of the day, the product sells.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to do your work and you have to make sure that you deliver what you're supposed to deliver. Other factors will always come and go.
Would you do a reality show for
you? No, not at this point. It's quite boring as a person, so I'll be thrown out the first week.
If given a chance, then which biopic you would like to portray yourself? Whose life story you would like to
Rajiv Gandhi.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
I was fascinated as a kid by Rajiv Gandhi. I think the journey, I would love to be a part of it maybe.
You have a political view?
No.
Tell us about your love life.
My love life. See,
about
my
that.
Love.
About your, you know, girlfriend rumored. Mouni.
Which girlfriend?
Mouni Roy.
See, as you said, rumored. So what am I supposed to clarify on that? So what am I
supposed to say? It's true or it's not true, or maybe or what?
She answered her question. She said rumored. You did.
First, I told you. Tell us about your love life. About somebody else.
So my love life is right now only this gym and this eating.
Come on, man.
Yeah, and I'm the right now the
nobody
project
believes you, huh?
Yeah,
they will have to, because right now I'm based in Gujarat border where I'm working on my next project.
So then you must be missing your girlfriend.
No, video call is there. With Mouni?
Yes.
See, to be on a very serious note, I have, you know, when I started working on that show, Mouni was already an established actress and she already had made a name for herself. And I only shot with her briefly for around 2 months or something of that sort, 2 to 3 months.
But you still must have gotten to know her. So what is the best thing you like about Mouni?
Best thing?
Since you've worked with her, you must be.
Like, she, because she's well-read, she has a tendency of learning lines very quickly. So if you give her a page or a two-page monologue, she'll just go through it and she'll be ready. So whoever is there in frame with her, he always has to be on his feet, you know, he's going to have a tough time.
Is that what impressed you?
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. That impressed me.
Are you insecure now that she's doing a film with Akshay Kumar?
Why should I be insecure? I'll be insecure if television actors are doing film with Anushka Sharma, right? Why should I be insecure about females doing films with Akshay Kumar or all those people?
So Anushka Sharma is favorite?
Yeah. Very much.
Who is your biggest competitor in TV industry right now? Whom do you consider?
I've never seen like that. I've always done things very differently. I've worked very differently. I've never seen who's doing what. I've just been doing my own work in my own. I've got those blinkers on, and I just do my job. I don't see who's doing what.
Mohit, how do you handle all the female adulation that you get?
How do I handle that?
Yeah.
I mean. See, first of all, it's you're humble. You just smile and you know you just say thank you and you're honored and I mean just like that. But yeah, I mean I just don't. Don't take it too seriously. I mean, just I take it seriously. I take the whatever they say very seriously, but I don't. I mean, I don't really take it to heart.
Last question.
How do you stay fit and what is your exercise regime like?
It depends what I'm the what kind of a project that I'm doing. Right now, the project that I'm working on, I'm supposed to be a little more athletic on that. So my fitness regime depends accordingly. It changes and varies from time to time.
Last question. Mouni is currently being known to be Salman Khan's favorite. What's your comment on it?
What's my comment on him? She's everybody's favorite, isn't she? I mean, yeah.
And yours too.
Mine too, yeah.
And since you told like you get very less time to talk to her, but whenever you meet her, so what's your idea for a perfect date?
I haven't met her for the longest time. We haven't, because I'm based in Gujarat nowadays.
Yeah, but your video calls work yeah. for you.
That's with the fans when they're entering the house.
Your love life, nothing else. You better tell them.
So that's for the fans when they enter.
Video calls with the fans.
Yeah, as I explained the incident when video call with the fan, I entered
so
his
you
house.
Don't video call Mouni.
Why should I do that? Why should I do that? I don't do that with my colleagues, and yeah.
He's too smart for y'all. Forget it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the unveiling is about to come to an end. Thank you so much, Mr. Narahira. Thank you, Vinodini. Thank you, Mohit. Please give them a huge round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you so much.